What's up, guys? Walled Off TV here with our first podcast. These things go down with conversations, I think. I don't really know, but like, here we go, okay?
Hello, I'm Joshua.
Oh, hey, I'm Peyton.
So how's everybody doing?
We're great.
What's going?
Doing great. I just took a vacation to Tennessee, and it was great. Road trips.
There you go. Vacation. It's June.
Nashville, Memphis.
I just got back.
A lively time.
Oh, see, I was gonna start, and then you started talking, and now it's awkward because you talked to
me. I enjoyed it thoroughly.
Okay. I went to Arizona. It was hot. I did not enjoy it thoroughly. It was actually kind of trash. Arizona.
110
mountains at least.
It's hikes. It's like bad mountains. It's like mountains that if you walked up, the very top would still be hot sand, not ooh ice or snow. Or like ooh, that's a good view.
You see. I saw a thing I think I Googled it, but like, you know how like Washington, the state, is like the most. It gets the most rain.
Yeah.
Like, it rains, like...
all the time.
So much. Arizona apparently only gets 10 days out of the year with rain.
And it's, like, all in a row, I think.
So...
really?
Yeah, they get, like...
10 out of 365.
Yeah, they get 10 days, and it's just, like... it's, like, monsoon season, except Phoenix.
I can live in a place that hot ever.
Could not.
It's nice because...
Could not.
It's nice because dry heat is definitely not as bad as humidity.
Yes, Texas.
Humidity is cancer.
So, if it's like 110.
If it's 110,
it feels
you walk
the same
outside
as like
no
90 here, but humidity.
I would rather
yeah
be outside at 110 degrees than it be 90 and like
humidity.
70% humidity. Mm. Because like when you go outside in humidity, it actually makes you want to not be outside and
want
to die.
When
it's hot,
alive.
Yeah, you're just like, I do not want to. Like, it drains your energy. Like, have you ever done stuff outside in 90, like, in humidity over 90 degrees? It's the worst.
Play volleyball.
You're just sticky. You feel gross the whole time.
Is it the most humid, like,
afternoon?
Or is it, like, midday when it's most humid?
Because
I think it's, like, when the sun is setting.
I don't think it's based on that. I think it's more based on
no
whether there's humidity in the air. Like, if it rained, there's a lot of evaporated air, so humidity.
Well, there's humidity. There's more humidity in the summer than ever, but it doesn't rain hardly in the summer.
Yeah, but when it
does.
It's because it's also hotter, so, like, lakes and waters.
Lakes and waters.
Evaporation. Oh, no, I don't know enough science.
I
am. I'm not a meteorologist, so.
That's like middle school.
Yeah.
Middle school life science.
What, the water cycle?
Earth science. Evaporation.
They taught us the water cycle like 20 times.
Yeah, I just...
you don't know the water cycle.
What are you talking about?
Put it in order.
Rain?
What's it called? What's this like?
Okay. You want me to go full science?
What's the scientific
precipitation.
I don't know it.
Precipitation.
Condensation.
It's
wait,
precipitation,
what?
Then there's like a weird word, like collection, I guess. Like, it just goes into a water source.
I know the word, but I can't think of it.
I can't think of it. We'll look
is
at
it.
Condensation? No, condensation
is the third
is,
one? The third one?
Condensation is after evaporation.
Correct.
It evaporates and condenses into clouds.
Condensation and then back to precipitation. So we just don't know the second one.
I'm looking it up.
Wait, so condensation is last or second to last?
Second
to last.
Before, I mean, it depends where you start. It's a cycle. There's no end.
Dang.
Made you look,
got me.
Science.
Made you look like an idiot.
Got me.
What
are you looking up?
I'm looking up...
the water cycle.
It just says groundwater. That's not helpful.
Surface runoff. No.
No, I think there's like...
we
collection.
Need the word.
It's collection. What did I say?
Precipitation, condensation.
You said communication.
No, I didn't say...
no.
Don't make me play it back. I won't.
No.
We can't right now.
Okay.
I'm making...
precipitation,
you
did not
say
collection, that. Evaporation, condensation.
Oh,
our first podcast, and we talk about the fucking water cycle.
Yeah. There we go.
We could, okay. I got a conversation. What song would you guys wake up to every morning for the rest of your life?
Crazy Train.
What?
Which?
Do I have to listen to the whole song?
The whole song every time you wake up in the morning, or whenever your morning is, because some people are weird and wake up at
Do I get to explain mine, or are you just gonna? Do I get to
because it helps wake you up?
No, because it says.
I cannot listen to that anymore. You cannot listen
every morning for the rest of your
life. You can't listen to any song every morning, but it'd be the best because it'd be
that would be a running joke after like a day.
I don't think
your
so.
Second morning awake.
No, that would be
you would get, you would wake up with instant energy. You wake up and you run out.
You wake up and it's like,
you would have to
my god, Ozzy Osbourne.
Yeah, you're just like, just
no, you would have to go to bed in running clothes because right when you wake up, you're like, energy, I gotta go take a run because I have so much energy. Let's go run a mile.
In that case, just do the freaking Rocky theme song.
That
wake up in a jumpsuit.
I don't know that song. Oh, does it start just like that?
Think.
Does it just go straight?
There's no words.
There's no intro. There's no like. Prelude?
Is it Google? Okay, Google.
No, you said
play the Rocky theme song.
All right, Gonna Fly Now by Bill Coney.
Is that it?
Playing on Spotify.
I guess.
Gonna Fly Now by Bill. There.
Yeah, that'd be a good. Actually, I'm not gonna lie, that's not a bad one.
Good one, Josh. Thanks, Josh. Welcome, Josh.
So there's an intro.
So, yeah, I'm
just instantly up.
You're just like, gotta go for my morning run.
I just imagine that happening, and you have to just go up with no arms, just like straight up.
Stop playing it.
Pause that.
Hey Google, stop playing music.
There we go.
That's so helpful.
Okay, so you could either, I would either cheat the system and pick like a 30-second song, I could just forget it, you know, not really notice it. Or I would pick.
Wait, how long does it take you to wake up? Because you don't have to listen to the whole song.
Yeah,
he did. He specified.
Yeah, oh, the whole song?
The whole song. Every morning, wake up, brush your teeth.
How long?
Go to the bathroom.
How long is Crazy Train?
You're listening to a 6-minute song every morning for your life.
Yeah, I'd have to pick like a 2-minute song.
Would I have to bring my phone with me? Because what if I just wake up in the first
It's like playing in within your brain. Like, you could hear it clearly. Like, you're listening to music.
I'm not going to lie, I pissed my pants the first time Crazy Train played in my head. I just heard Ozzy Osbourne talk, like, screaming in my ear. I would cry.
I'd pick. I can't pick something soothing because then I'm not going to wake up.
It's in your head, though.
An R&B song, I'm just going to stay asleep.
Wait, yeah, now that I think about it, like, if it was an R&B song, you may just think it's part of your dream. Keep going.
I fall asleep to music.
I don't think I heard that's bad.
I would choose How's Just a Kid.
Because then, like, if you try to go to sleep without music, it's hard.
It is.
Really?
Yeah, it is. Get, like,
my whole trip in Tennessee, I slept every night without a phone, and it kind of sucked.
You should have had headphones.
But
Generation Z? You are Generation Z. No, you're not.
No, millennials end in 94.
Yeah.
Really?
Everyone calls them millennials.
Every time I talk to every other person about it, they're like, no, you're a millennial. And then I'm like, oh, okay.
It's just because people are
then I talk
dumb.
To somebody else, and they're like, no, you're Generation Z.
Yeah, it's millennials.
And then
I think it's us. I think we're Y.
I think we're Generation No, we're not Generation X.
No,
no, we're Generation Y, and then the next generation that's like right now.
2014, I think,
is
started it.
Generation Z.
How did this change? I would wait.
Like people that grew up with smartphones when they were like 6, and have smartphones.
I hate that. I see like 2-year-old kids like with an iPad and headphones.
It makes
of, like,
me sad.
A toy.
It makes me feel a little.
Yeah,
bit less.
Legos.
It makes me feel a little
Legos,
less of a person.
Mega blocks.
Stuffed animals.
Okay, I never played.
You know
that,
what I'm saying? Just toys in general.
Action figures.
But, like, now the kids, like, parents just don't want to be annoyed, so they just give kids, like, headphones and an iPad, and so they just watch a little show for it.
Nothing's more humbling than seeing a 6-year-old with a better phone than me. It's just like, dang. You don't even know how to use that. They're probably
That's
great
true.
With that phone.
They probably
don't know how to use that. Like,
tech whizzes.
But.
Well, I think I would choose Just a Kid by Two Friends to wake up to every morning.
I don't know what that song is. Hey Google, play Just a Kid by Two Friends.
All right, Just a Kid by Two Friends.
You're gonna love it.
Playing on Spotify.
I'm gonna hate it on purpose.
How long is this?
I think it's 3 minutes? 2 minutes?
Oh
two
my gosh, I know what I would pick.
Hey, I'm just a kid, I don't need money. Little lost, but one day they'll talk of me. I'll have the world.
I would just be
okay.
Very like.
You pause it? Okay.
I'd be. Hey,
That would turn into nightmares.
Like you one more sip. Wait.
Okay. Wait. How?
That's like a minute. It's 5 minutes long.
5 minutes?
This isn't good.
Not the mood.
That's not the look.
Hey Google.
Okay. I got it. Don't worry.
Sorry.
Okay, but
just stop talking to
just a 5 minute song every morning. You have to fully listen to. Just think how long 5 minutes actually is.
My apologies. I don't understand.
It was still listening because Josh was
yeah.
talking. He just kept talking, so that's how you were talking to it.
I think, yeah, like a 2.5 minute song. Two and a half minutes.
I'm going for I don't want to put a song that I like then. Because if I like it, I'm going to hate it after like 3 days. Because
like radio.
Like
song, you hear a song and you're like, oh, banger. And then it's on the radio and it plays 30 times a day, and then you get tired of it.
Hear it one time on the radio, and it's instantly like leaves a bad taste in my mouth.
It's not as good anymore.
Yeah, it's because like, or this. I feel like this is bad, but like, if I see someone that I think is kind of annoying, mm-hmm. and they play a song that I am banging at the moment, instantly I'm just like, I can't listen to it. You ruined the song for me. Like, do you not like ever, like, you're jamming out to like. Like, you get on Post Malone, you're listening to it, and then you hear, like, someone you hate just start listening to it. I haven't listened to Post Malone since, like, for, like, 3 weeks.
Yeah.
And I love that album.
Yeah.
It's just, like,
I don't really
everyone's playing it.
I don't really hate people, but,
like, that's not hate, it's more, like,
things people do.
Their music choice is annoying, because, like, you're in the car.
Because they're annoying?
And they suggest a Nicki Minaj song that's just, like,
okay, I don't know anyone who would suggest a Nicki Minaj song.
I know.
Chung Lee's a good song. No lie. No lie.
I don't think I've heard it.
Is that the one that's like, I'm a dirty hoe?
No.
There's like one
Nicki
that's all of her song.
Nicki goes hard at Chung Lee. She goes hard at that song. No lie.
There's a good question. Is there any...
You want to listen to it?
No, we've played like six songs.
I think it means bad guy in Japanese. I think so. Because that's what the song's based on. It means like bad guy.
So she's talking about herself being a bad guy?
I don't know.
Chun-Li is the character of Capcom Street Fighter.
So she's a Street Fighter.
Here's a good question.
So she's a Street Fighter.
Wait.
She's Tekken.
The first female fighter in the series is literally that.
It is? The first female fighter.
So I guess she's a female fighter?
She's
female
she's
power?
She's repping the females.
Okay.
Is there any...
Okay, now that I look at it in that sense, it does make
let's
sense.
Talk about it like this. Are there any good female rappers? Answer, no.
There's a couple Cardi B songs that I like, but I know you hate Cardi B.
Cardi B.
I don't like any, the only reason I don't like about girls rap is because they talk about their vagina way too much. It just makes me gross out a little. And like, once they gross me out, it's like their whole mute. Like, I would definitely say Nicki Minaj is better than
Cardi B. They do talk about their junk in the trunk a lot.
I'm just
but I mean,
pull up.
Well, you gotta brag about something.
They
guys.
At least they back it up. They back
I don't
it
like
up.
Talk. I don't like listening to guys talking about throwing their penis around either.
Yeah.
I don't listen to those musics either. So it's not not like this is just a sexist thing. I just don't like people talking about their junk like that.
You don't like people talking about their stuff or them. Yeah. No, I get it.
Yeah.
I get
it. Yeah. It's just like keep it in your pants, or if you don't keep it in your pants, keep it in your mind. Don't say it to me.
There's also way more guy rappers than girl rappers. And I think that's because girls are such naturally...
good singers?
No. Girls, like... girls
they
just,
are.
Like, hate each other way easier than guys hate each other. So, like... I don't know.
They get ripped on
at
their
know.
Beginning
I think,
stage.
I think
like,
like
there's like 50. I could name like 30 guy rappers right now, but I couldn't name more than like five or three.
I couldn't or name two. More than three. Nicki and Cardi, girl rappers.
I know there's that one. Iggy isn't a rapper.
There's not room for. Like they always one gets big and then. And then the one that's currently big has to be like
dethrone the other one.
You can't come up here. Like there's not room for two people.
It's weird because like they're like, oh yeah, she's the queen. Like Cardi B's the queen. As if there's like only one spot for a female rapper, which is
weird. There's 30
and also it's like I feel like they have to like
Rihanna,
because like she's not a rapper. She's like a singer that talks sometimes.
It's a bad
I feel like they have to make it like where they argue with each other. Like they get like Cardi B and Nicki because like you because like rap is like based on like
what about Bad Baby.
Oh shoot! Catch Me Outside.
Catch Me Outside.
Would rather die than listen to any of her songs. I've seen one of her videos. Why? I was like, how did you get this much money to make this production?
How old is she?
Probably 18 now.
18?
Maybe. I thought 16.
I'll look it up.
I know she couldn't drive even during that video, so she had to be like 15.
Bro, I bet she's like 15 now. Maybe.
16. I think 16 now.
She's 15.
I called it.
I freaking called it.
What are you talking about? I said 15 during the video.
You said 16 now, though.
Okay.
Guess what? But I said 15.
It's just like, they have to, like, because, like, it's all about beef. Like,
yeah.
Drake and Pusha.
And I don't know if that.
And they have to beef with each other, because you can't, like, a female rapper can't really beef with a male rapper, because the male rapper will look like a dick if he goes back and just ruins her life. It's like,
yo, you a
bitch. It's like, damn. Whoa, push
away. Oh, wait. I can't.
Oh, I'll bleep it.
Okay. Alright.
So,
I don't know. Are the girl rappers bringing the beef onto each other, or is it like all the fans or like all.
I mean, Nicki and Cardi don't have no problems.
The only thing I've heard from Nicki Minaj is that I remember there was like. She said something that, like, a bunch of people were pissed off about, that, like, white people are, like, ruining rap music, or there's no good rap.
White people ruining?
Or, like, they, like, posted a picture of the top charts, and, like, G-Eazy was on the top, like, trending, and, like, it was Russ, maybe? And she was like, wow, it must be good to be white right now in the rap game. And I was like, wow.
Dang. Well.
Russ and G-Eazy really don't get that much cred. It's not like they're that great.
No one's like,
oh yeah.
Best rappers, G-Eazy.
I met someone who said that. They said their favorite rapper was
best
G-Eazy.
Best rapper, go. G-Eazy.
G-Eazy, Russ. MGK.
Logic. Kelly. People would say Logic, though.
But I thought he's tough.
Oh, yeah.
He is. He's mixed. He's mixed.
I know.
I forget
he
about
says
that.
It in every single one of his songs.
Yeah.
At least once.
And he's like, I'm black, guys. Come on. He's always like trying to prove that he's black. It's like, people that are saying are that he isn't black.
Literally,
it's just like
go
people
listen
are
to,
trying to troll.
Go listen to any of his songs. He's gonna say it once that he's half black and white. I'm gonna be honest. I don't like him that much just because he says that a lot.
Like, looks like Michael Jackson after he bleached himself.
He reminds me of Steph Curry.
He doesn't look one thing of black. He's fully white.
He's got curly hair though.
Okay. But so does Austin. Oh, well, Austin's half Asian and half white.
Asian people have curly hair? I don't know. I don't think so. Mine's straight.
It Yours came from his mom, I think. I guess, I don't know.
You need me to pull out some topics? Don't worry, guys. I got you.
Yeah, I could cut from like right here to whenever.
What's your biggest fear?
Oh, biggest fear? Mine is easy. Joshua knows this. I'm pretty sure I know yours, Josh. I can say it right now. He's scared of airplanes.
Flying, in general.
No reason to. I am...
Hold up. Why?
I genuinely don't know.
It's safer.
The last time I flew was when I was 3. I'm 19 now. I haven't flown since... But the last time I flew, I don't think I'm traumatized.
I don't think you remember.
But the last time I flew, I had like a 103 fever, and we were coming back from...
When you were three?
Yeah, we were coming back from a cruise. We were coming back from a cruise, and I got sick. Did
you go on a cruise when you were three?
Yeah, to like the Caribbean or
something. That's not a good idea, Sharon.
I got sick like the second day, and then I spent the whole week sick, and then the whole fly back, I was like deathly ill.
I would probably not take my kids out of the country until they're like 10.
Yeah, because don't you have to get your shots to go out of the country?
Yeah,
or whatever?
I was three.
No, I don't think you have to have a passport when you're three.
No, I mean like shots, like... To not
oh,
get
yeah.
diseases.
But I think I remember getting them, maybe. No, I don't know. But I bet I did.
To bring back diseases.
Yeah, I guess.
Or whatever.
I think it's just...
I don't even have my...
The fact right. that there's a small layer of floor under me, and then under that small layer of floor is 30,000 feet of sky. And if somehow I... go from being in the plane.
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Oh, definitely.
Is it 30,000?
30,000.
I think so.
I thought it was a mile.
A mile up?
Like mile high. Isn't that what they call it? The Mile High Club? When you smash on the
Mile High Club.
Okay.
I think
I don't
it's 30,000.
That's accurate.
I hear
30,000. It's 30,000.
Yeah, I hear 30,000.
Except helicopters go like 5,000, I think, because...
Traffic.
It's not closed. It's not enclosed.
Or yeah. Okay, yeah, I totally get it. The airplane, but have you? So you haven't been on one since.
Are you scared of crashing, or are you just scared of airplane? Oh yeah, 36,000.
There's only 40,000. Because there's only one thing that could go right, and that's you get from point A to point B safely, which is likely. The statistics are proven that more times
flights
go right.
You could. That's
but
the same thing with the car.
That
you're, making
could go right.
You're making me afraid.
But there's like 500 million different things, and then I just think, oh my gosh, let me think about all the things
stuff.
That could happen.
Okay.
I'm pretty sure you are 100 times more likely to die in a car crash than an airplane crash.
Don't care. Maybe
also
I don't have a fear of flying. Maybe I have a fear of not being in control of my own life.
Right, because if it goes down... Because
I can drive a car. I trust
you
people...
You get T-boned.
I trust people
I trust
when I passenger in a car.
I trust the air more than people driving.
But I don't trust... Like, I can't do anything about it if I'm on a plane.
And one thing...
And something goes
say
wrong.
Say engine shuts off.
Boom.
I think the only thing that can go wrong while you're flying is, like, comparable to your car just blowing up or someone jacking you while you're in your car. Because either someone airjacks you and then crashes you into a building, or the plane has a malfunction. Because the pilots, it's not that hard.
Okay.
It's like autopilot.
Let me just have my fear.
Okay.
Okay. And...
I would like to talk... Actually, I thought about something to talk about. I remember you called me and you were talking about something about how, like, when they tell you to put your head down in a car in a plane crash... They're doing that so everyone dies.
Quicker? Oh, I saw that once.
Right. So you can't sue the airline.
I saw that on an Instagram page. Like,
I don't
that's
think
that's, like, the fastest
I don't think that's right.
Like, and then...
It is right, logically, because if your head is down, you're going to die quicker. Because,
you're going to...
But if your knees are up
I think,
on the
I,
back
but,
rest of the chair, break your legs first, then you might.
But most of the time, when you're crashing...
Then you might die.
But when,
jeez.
When you're crashing, most of the time, you're not hitting down... Like, straight down where all the force would break your neck. It's usually up, so if you did this, your body would go up, not into the chair and break your neck. Physics. Like, it goes, it crashes, usually
know.
Plane crash would crash like this.
Let's
not,
just simulate an airplane crash and see what happens.
Also, I don't think that would help the airline. Because.
What?
If they.
For people to die?
Which one would sound better?
Instead of people's.
We crashed an airplane and everyone died. We crashed an airplane and 50% of the people survived. Good job, guys. Hey, our airplanes, only 50% of the people die compared to that airline where everyone's dead. Get on our airplanes.
But then you just, you always have like, oh my gosh, the equipment. You can blame it on the equipment. Like, oh my gosh, everything went wrong.
So
we couldn't do anything
about
it.
Let's say we're all going on a vacation. On a vacation.
I don't think they can
on.
Do that. Because remember Sully got, remember that one movie Sully? Where he
yes,
gets like sued?
That's a true story, I think.
Yeah, he gets sued because the plane crashed and they're like, you could have done more.
What?
Yeah. He gets sued by the government or something like that.
Didn't he save everyone, though?
He...
No one died, I'm pretty sure.
There was injuries, though.
But
But he landed on the Hudson River. No one died, and he crashed into the Hudson River. And they were like, you could have done more or something like that.
What? That sounds familiar.
Yeah, and they like sued him. So like,
dang.
I don't think it's.
I just, if I saved everybody's life. I think it's more life, like,
if you crash.
Bro, there's nothing more I could have done to save everybody.
If I saved everybody on a
plane. I need a freaking peace prize.
And then I get sued.
It's because they were trying to say that he could have avoided things that caused the accident. But it was like a bird flying into the engine and breaking the engine.
So like a freak accident, yeah.
Yeah, and they were like.
Operator error?
He was like, I'm not gonna.
What was a bird doing 40,000 feet in the air?
And then they were landing.
Oh, okay, I was like, jeez.
I think. I don't know. I haven't seen the movie in a while. Stop asking so many questions.
Stop fact checking. I'm just saying.
Yeah, don't judge me.
Okay.
I need y'all's fears.
Okay. You want to go or?
No, you go. Mine's a little more interesting than yours for sure.
Probably not.
Johnny. If we're going to be completely honest, so okay, I'm Cambodian, okay? So I believe in spirits and all that. I don't want no demon crawling up inside me. If I'm being completely honest.
Do demons crawl into people?
Okay, I've seen the exorcisms, like every single one of them.
I think you just get up in your body, not like
I don't know, like, that is my biggest fear. Just like something that's never walked the earth that's supposed to be like, ugh. Like, all up in me, and then like taking control, and then like breaking my fingers, and then when I get back into my own body, I'll be like, dang, why are my fingers broken?
What? You're scared? Of all the things a demon could do to you, he's like, oh, I would break the fingers.
He could like turn my whole neck around, and then I come back and I'm dead because my neck's broken, you know?
I wouldn't mind that if anything. Like,
you wouldn't mind being possessed by a demon?
No, if a demon killed me instantly, thank you, because you could do much worse.
Okay, true that. Yeah. You could like.
I don't think a demon has the power to kill someone though.
Break your neck?
Does it?
No.
I've seen it, the exorcism.
A spirit? I don't think it has the power.
You've seen the exorcism? Yeah, that really proves what demons can do.
Okay, no, I've seen like all of them, documentaries of it. I don't know why I watched them. It's just interesting. But then
you're adding to the fear.
Exactly. You're that's my biggest fear. Oh my gosh, it is. Okay, you know, like.
So fear of being possessed by demons.
Yes.
Fear of planes.
Fear of getting curb stomped. Let me say, it is, like, the worst thought to think, like, someone smashed my teeth into my mouth. I don't have teeth. And then there's, like, shards of teeth going into my gums.
Is it, like, your mouth open?
They
make you bite it?
No, they put your teeth. Let me explain. They put your teeth on the edge of a curb, like that. And then they stomp on your head until your teeth shatter. And they probably break your skull a little.
So it's like unimaginable pain, and you like
and you
live
use,
through it.
And you live through it.
And you experience it.
And you're just there. And to get you there, you can't do anything.
Your face
probably
is gone.
They probably destroyed you. They beat you up at this point. They drag you to a curb and curb stomp you.
But when would you ever be in a situation where you get curb stomped?
No, that is just his biggest fear.
When would you be in a position where you're... your plane would crash.
Anytime I'm on a plane.
Anytime you're curved.